I just dug something a few feet over from that thimble.
Yeah.
And when you see this, if it's what I think it is, you're absolutely not going to believe it. That's wood. And look at what's inside of it.
What?
That is absolutely amazing. So do you believe it, Ripley?
Believe it or not, there it is.
Is it open?
It's open, and it is the largest open well I've ever seen.
Well, let's go look at it.
All right.
And then we'll tell them what's going on. And just a little bit of side information. I realize that I have been filming like this the last 2 months with the stabilizer off.
You are good, man.
Imagine that. I was cleaning my stuff the other day and went, oh, my God. No wonder why I don't breathe when I shoot. So... let's check out the well.
You can see where the rock line is that far.
Is it a cistern?
It could be a cistern, but I hiked all around in really ugly over there, and I couldn't find another well.
Hmm.
It could be a cistern.
Very cool.
It's a big hole in the ground.
Yeah. All right, let's bring them up to speed.
Well, you guys remember how last month we took the Mahindra out into the massive area in Dame's neighborhood, somewhere in New Hampshire.
Somewhere.
Yeah, and it was really thin on the finds, but we found some cool sites. Well, we're back out today to cover more ground.
We're going further out.
Yeah, this ought to be fun.
It's gonna be fun either way.
Yeah.
But further, maybe means less people.
Let's hope. So we're gonna get in and go.
All right, so here we go. The checking of site number one. Well, we haven't confirmed yet, but it's just screaming to us. Home site.
It's been a minute. Dame's already pulling something out of the ground. It is our assumption that this place has already been pounded, cleaned out, just like a lot of the other ones we saw last time. But the point is we need to explore. We need to micro-tune the area and see if we can find sites that have not been found.
80.
Mm. So as it's working lately, you've got to go where people would have had a difficult time metal detecting. Hence, I like to work in the iron, and Dame likes to work...
in the pucker brush.
Yeah.
I can't reach it.
Hold on. Oh, man. You gotta go where it's not easy, especially at places like this. Just the fact that you heard an 80 despite of whatever it is.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Huh. Well, that'll give you an 80.
Right, but what is it?
I don't know. It's busted.
Flat in Baton Rouge.
It's mounted to something. It's a good target.
Yeah.
It's enough for me to stick around in the pucker.
Yeah, we'll give it a few and see what else happens. Well, I just took a walk pretty far out. Dig holes way out there.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Look at that, Dame.
Really nice suspension.
That is a beauty.
And I can give a little educational for our viewers, too. It rang up exactly like that rang up.
That makes sense, yeah.
So you got to dig them, even if you're digging... a lot.
Right. Good. Well, objective of simplicity was reached. At least one relic from a site.
And it's a nice one, too. I don't think I've got a suspender clasp like that.
Yeah, that is very nice. All right. I obviously have a decent signal, but Dame just went, huh? Oh, wow. So let's go check him out in the ferns there.
So that was a 78.
Oh, yeah, it does look like a part of the other. Oh, snippage.
Jeez. Look at that thing. So it looks like it.
Wow, you're pretty far away from the other.
Yeah.
Extraction.
I mean, I still don't know what it is, but.
Jeez, it almost had a butt plate quality to it. Not necessarily a firearm.
Right.
But, you know, a plate that would butt something.
Yeah.
That's cool, Dame.
Yeah, completion on that.
Yeah, definitely a future find worth hanging on to, because someday you may find out.
Yeah, I'm going to keep it.
Good. All right, I'm going to go check my signal, because it's the best one I've had so far.
I heard it.
And then we'll go from there.
Do it up.
So, three consecutive lead signals in a row. I scraped the dirt back. Same signal. And look at that. A ball button. Awesome. So I got my relic for the site. Very happy.
And my guess would be that whoever worked over here wasn't digging those, you know, 50 to 60, which is mid, creeping towards high tones, because I just dug three pieces of lead. So, again, today we are on an expedition to explore, document. We got a couple relics out of there that was very good, but currently where we're parked. So the road goes that way, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Big tree, wall goes this way. We're sitting in
a V.
Traffic triangle.
Yes, we are. Yeah.
We need to go where it doesn't look like anybody's gone.
All that, we gotta try to get through that.
Actually, it makes a lot of sense now with this traffic circle. All right, let's roll.
Yep.
Boy, it's deep. Geez, that does look kind of like it's got a channel going through it.
Yeah. Whoa.
Glad I got out of the way for that one.
Maybe a tree over there too.
Boy, it looks like a cart path coming up in here. And we have wall. We're here.
Well, I'm gonna say this lift, just by the wall, look at it, it's gingerbread.
Yep.
Boy, looks old. Well, we've been swinging around here, nothing but ammo and lots of work. Up here to the right is beautiful, flat, cleaned, and then there's lots of piles of rocks from clearing it, and over there where we parked was very almost decorative, just like you'd find near a home site.
It sure does feel like one, but we're not finding anything, so we're gonna venture out some more.
Stinky. That's what I smelled out in the woods.
Farty.
Wow.
Ugh. Well, at least we made it.
Yep.
All right, so we just stopped because we saw something in this really bad rocky section. There is 20 feet of wall right here. And it is absolutely loaded with bricks. Wow. Dame, it's loaded with bricks.
What?
Yeah, exactly. There's no hole, but that really could have been the retaining wall, the foundation, and all these bricks are obviously from a chimney stack. And we have got some, wow, massive iron.
Full set of barrel loops, top, bottom, and middle.
Wow.
There's no shortage of large metal.
So this is just the stuff I'm picking up off the surface. These things are no idea, but that's some fantastic metal. These things could definitely be repurposed somehow. But this place is very, very different than the norm. And it's build and, you know, just what we're finding on the surface. All right, Dame's over here swinging, and he's got a find.
I think it's a rock splitting wedge.
Really? Oh, that is a nice wedge. Very good.
Yeah.
Good. I'm glad something that could be carried out was found at the site.
Yep.
Wonder what this guy was making over here.
I don't know, but there's a big iron bed here. Yep. Up on this flat. Probably at a barn or workshop. What a strange little site.
Yeah, it's completely different than everything else.
Yeah. So, that was a very interesting site. Definitely a foundation wall. Lots of bricks, probably from a chimney. Lots of massive iron.
Big iron and an iron bed that extends so far out on two sides of the house. It even went up the hill to that huge Volkswagen stone.
Huh. So what we're going to do, being that we've been out for a long time, it's getting late. There is a third potential site. Actually, be four at this point. That at some point we're hoping to try and find. But for now, we think we're just going to travel down the road a bit to where we think we need to go into the woods and just see if it's possible. And
we'll go as far as we can go.
Yeah, let's see what's down this road.
Whoa, look at that.
Oh. Jesus, huh?
Damn. Oh. I can't even see the top.
Wow.
We don't want to go up there today.
No.
Oh, wow.
Nice.
Notice how now we just refer to it as an up? Look at that up. Oh, cool, little waterfall.
Oh, yeah.
That's beautiful.
Oh, wow, look at that wall. Oh, wow.
It's a bridge. Is that a bridge?
Huh.
It's stacked rock on this side, too.
Really?
Yeah.
We see cart path over there?
Not
one.
Maybe.
Well, that is intriguing.
Huh. I think it went down here and then up that way.
Well, we'll put that on the list.
Yeah.
Keep in mind, as we take you all exploring out here with us, you know, the curiosity factor is higher than the find factor. This is colonial New England. We are out in an area that was settled in the 1700s and has been abandoned for 150 years easily. So it's just remarkable to do that. These are, you know, American ruins.
So why we stopped here is because the road split at this little river. And where Dame is walking down there, we're just curious as to see which side looks older. That side does have some rock shoulder to it. I mean, really, look at this landscape. So you can see the road up there. It's definitely got rocks in it. But just look across the way. It just goes up. So much granite. It's brutal. Brutal that somebody cut a road through here. Oh yeah, that's shouldered. That's been there a long time.
So before we call it a day, we've made our way back to where we started, where that big well or cistern was.
Yep. Right there.
Because there's a cellar hole in there, and it's really overgrown, as you can see. But we're going to try swinging in front of it for a few minutes just to, you know, round off the day nicely.
Yeah.
And we haven't yet.
That's right.
So this is how rough a shape.
Telling me, man.
This hole is in. Dame and I are right now. This is the lip. This is working the lip. I gotta get over to him because he just found an interesting glass item.
Wow.
Yeah, we should come back here in February.
Yeah. So it's gone purple, so it's pretty old. The top is busted off, but. And then whatever rim it had was busted off.
Huh.
Yeah. I don't know, man.
That's cool. Definitely take that with you. All right, I'm gonna swing in here.
Good luck.
For 10 seconds. All right, so I've already extracted several ammunition shells, and this was no more than 2 inches under the surface.
Oh, wow.
Is that a... grab it, bugs. Is that a thimble?
It is definitely a thimble.
Wow. Talk about saving it in its last days.
Yeah, well, that's not bad. There's like 2 feet of lip over here to swing on.
I see it. It's right there.
Right there. All right, good. Well, I'm going to tickle up in here.
I just dug something a few feet over from that thimble.
Yeah.
And when you see this, if it's what I think it is, you're absolutely not going to believe it.
All right, so that's wood.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
This was, growing out of the ground. Flip it over in my hand and look at what's inside of it.
What? It's brass.
All right, you hold it. And you extract it. It's knurled.
It is a thimble.
That is a thimble in wood.
That grew into here. That's the way to keep it right there.
That is absolutely amazing. I thought it was going to be a slug in the wood. So do you believe it, Ripley?
Believe it or not, there it is.
So I've just quickly come across to the barn side before we go, it's getting dark, and this screaming signal turns out to be a curry comb. So very good, got another relic. Rough shape, but very cool. Dame just scored a massive surface find hinge.
Yeah, it's busted off at the end. Or maybe not. That's hammered, yeah.
Oh, that's definitely.
Look at those nails, though. Look at the heads on them.
Yeah. Definitely take that back. Hang that on the...
Woof. I'll find a place for it.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah, nice surface find.
It's a good day.
It was a good day. That was awesome to go that far out into the middle of the old abandoned town.
And that's exactly what it is. This is a network of a community that stretches way. And, you know, these old roads and cart paths, they brought people home, so it's a very cool thing.
Yeah, and although the area appears to have been hit really hard by other detectorists probably over the last 30 years, as you can see, we're out for the exploration, but we're still finding things. Those two thimbles in a sea of other, you know, ammunition signals, awesome.
Thimble in wood.
Yeah. So I'm glad we stopped here for 15 minutes. Sometimes that's all it takes. All right. We still got to get out of here, so we'll see you all very soon. Till next time, enjoy your night.
Thursday.